we are at the foot of the steps to the high road to Kun Lai Pass. And we've got a grummy to speak to. This path leads to Kun Lai Summit. Good fortune to those who travel it to shop at grummy shops. Is it grummy or grummel? It's grummel. Oh dear, that's embarrassing. So, yes. Let's walk these paths. I hope everyone's doing all right. But we'll have a look and see what's going on here. Ah, history of the Veiled Star and a lore walker here. Winding like a snake between the fertile lowlands of the Valley of the Four Winds and rolling steps of Kun Lai Summit, the Veiled Star is truly a Pandaren wonder. It was hand-chiseled by Pandaren slaves during the Third Mogul Dynasty. To the best of our knowledge, this means the steps are over 12,000 years old. The Grummels believe it is very lucky for travelers to count the steps as they ascend. This may be true, but no one has ever been able to agree on a definite count. So how many do you see? Oh dear, alright. Lore Walker Shuchun, are you Tauren from beyond the mists? What a crazy age we're living in. Just needed a moment to rest here. These steps can really take it out of you, going up or down. Lots of steps so far, but I'm not really going to count them, I don't think. Because this is the path of 100 steps, and I can only assume that there is 100. I have some more travelers here from Four Winds. We'll pass these guys by, we'll let them rest. Probably quite exhausted. I'm sure these goats don't have a problem. It's a bell, a couple of cartwheels. And some high road grummels. Right. Ah, and there's the cart. Here we are. Now, this was a very important area. I'll show you why in just a second. But one of the main areas, or reasons why this was a good place, was because up here was the black market. It's not here anymore, it's been moved. I think it was only really here for Pandaria and maybe Legion, but here was Madame Goya. And you would be able to buy interesting things like a Donmara cub. I could bid on that if I wanted to. Oh, Karate Pandak. Interesting. Let's see, what was it? So I got a cockatiel and a Senegal. They had a parrot cage. Hyacinth macaw.
Live for your dreams.
Which is this. It's similar to the macaw we already have. But a different colour. Probably hard to get. Ah, it's a world drop. And then the other one is a Dunmora cub. Here it is, a little black bear cub. Which we could get from Derek Brindlebeard in Ice Crown for 40 of the currency there. The bears of Dunmora are prized for their hardiness, loyalty, and combat prowess. Their time among the dwarves does little to curb their ferocity. Well,
you have come to the right.
There's also a season 12 cape for 20,000 gold, blood-soaked invitation to the Brawler's Guild. Another season 12 bit of gear for 20k. Reigns of the Blue Drake for 34k. Reigns of the Blue Drake. It would only show me the mounts that I've already got. That's a shame. Okay. obvious that, you know, people are still popping around here. It's nice to know that it's still kind of frequented. It was very unique. There was some things you could only get through the black market. But never mind that. There's also this pub. I remember it for two reasons. Number one, there's a hot tub in the back. Number two, there's a special guest at the inn. Rathian, the Black Prince.
Is there such a thing as a righteous war?
Welcome, Druid. My contracts through Pandaria tell me that you have been quite busy here. I admire mortals with your initiative. History finds us at a turning point. If you're prepared to meet destiny with me head on, I will ensure that you are richly rewarded for your efforts. Well, I already know who you are, bud, but who are you? I have chosen the name Rathian. To my knowledge, I'm the last of the Black Dragons. My father was Deathwing, the Worldbreaker, the Aspect of Death, the Destroyer. But I hope you'll not hold that against me. I have no love for my father, whose corruption destroyed my race, or for the Red Dragonflight, who stole away and experimented on my egg to create me. Let's just say I'm unaffiliated. And I'm always on the lookout for like-minded heroes. So, well, we're obviously going to grab that too, the candy bucket. Here is the wrestler.
Yes.
Oh, good lord. I was not expecting that noise coming out from him. What does the coach have to say? Wrestler gonna punch Wicked so hard in the face it's going to improve Tauren looks. I see. Interesting. Well, had a little fun in the hot tubs there. Anything upstairs that we can interact with? A forgotten lockbox with a fuck ton of money in it. Alright. I'll take that. Interesting. Well, the Saurok and the Jinyu, a little book over here in the corner. How many pages is that? Oh, two. A Jinyu once sat by the side of a river, contemplating this and that, when along came a Saurok. The Jinyu was nervous at first and prepared to lunge into the river to get away. But the Saurok raised his hands and said, "I wish only to cross the river, but I do not know how to swim. You are a swimmer. Perhaps I could ride your back to the other side." At this, the Jinyu replied, "But you will stab me, or bite me, or try to eat my head." The Saurok laughed at this and claimed, "And this will kill us both, for if I kill you, I would drown." The Jinyu thought on this and then agreed with some effort. The heavy Saurok climbed onto the back of the Jinyu, and the two began to swim across the river. But as they travelled deeper into the water, the Saurok, without thinking, slew the Jinyu with a simple practice move of its claws. As the Jinyu sank to the bottom of the river, so did the heavy Saurok. Even at the risk of its own life, the Saurok could not escape his nature. Now, I've heard that story be told many different ways. Usually a scorpion and a frog. But it seems as if our story does not start there today. In our handful of treats, we get some more tricky treats so we can go a little faster. And some toothpicks. Len, the Whisperer here, has something for us. "I'm the retrieval expert for Her Ladyship, Madame Goya. It is her will that guides the ebb and flow of travel in this road. It is my role, to ensure certain less scrupulous types do not take advantage of Her Ladyship's hospitality. Robbing robbers of robbers." Ah, a druid, I could make good use of your skills. "A convoy was struck just up the road by a band of marauding Saurok. The These marauders made off with some merchandise. Her ladyship, the Madame Goya, had a mind to sell. One does not steal from her ladyship. If you recover these items, I will gladly provide you with a finder's fee. So we need to recover 7 black market merchandise. Also, we have one called Educating Saurok. I wonder what this could be about. The Spring Road is under the protection of her ladyship, the esteemed Madame Goya. The Saurok of Hate Scale Burrow, northeast of here, require education in this fact. We have warned them before, but sadly they seem to have been have a very short memory. Travel northeast to this burrow and find their shaman leader. Eliminate him, and you will have the gratitude of her ladyship, as well as the appropriate bounty. And we need to defeat Leech Fingers.
There is no
point. Okay. I can do that. I realize as well, as I'm doing this, I'm yawning. And I do apologize for this. I am very tired. I didn't expect me to. It's like, you know, people who sell drugs getting high off their own product. It's not really something you should be doing. At this point, I've had a unorthodox video out for a couple of days. It is a Disney Dreamlight Valley video, and I have absolutely no idea how well it's going to go. If it does go well, I will continue it, but I'm really not sure. I'm hoping if anybody has watched it or knows of it, let me know how it worked for them. So there's some black market merchandise. Oh dear. I've got some black market merchandise over there as well. We can get that. Scale burrow, that's fine. We really don't need to kill any of these guys, so I shouldn't really be prioritizing them. But I keep getting these shooting stars. Doing our best. It seems there's a definite difference in the amount of health that we have, which is nice. There we go. See, got another one procced immediately. to windward from this, which is very nice. We'll just get a lot of XP from this, so I'm not too fast. And this is our last piece of merchandise. What I think I'll do... What will I do here? I think I'll go stealth. Out quite nicely for us. Now, where's their shaman? There it is. Anything fantastic? Don't know we can. Be fucked here, but I'm honestly not too sure how fucked. Apparently not so much fucked. No, we're alright, we should be fine. Got some good gear now, otherwise we would not have been able to get away from that. And I'll wait here on this top road. There we are. Splendid.
Hello.
Alright, then. Saurok is seldom this bold. Well, there's your stuff back. Our merchandise. Madame Goya will be pleased. You have my gratitude of her ladyship.
Next one is on.
Sick. The deed is done, and a debt must be paid. Here is your reward. You have our gratitude.
May the mists protect.
Sweet. Now, there is another thing up here. I'm fairly certain this was the entrance to a dungeon. The Gate of Endless Spring. Yeah, this would have been for the Terrace of Endless Spring, which... was one of the raids. Oh, yes, I remember this one. Okay. There we go. Right, let's make a move. We'll carry on up this way. Past the Saurok. And we'll see where it goes. Dead high road crumble. So sad. A has Saurok probably got to it? And what's this? Brewmaster Boof. An eggshell. Is that really your name? If you head northwest, look for the Grummel Bazaar. Many good trinkets and lucky do's to sell there. Good fortune to be found for those who seek it. Okay, fair enough. The Brew Moon Festival, which I assume
enough
is... Brew Moon Festival, I've got no idea. Oh well.
What do you need?
I'd like to buy from you very quickly. No?
Until
okay.
Next time.
Yeah.
This is usually a calm stop. Now look at it. Where did all these Yongle come from? Ah, yes, the Yongle. The Spring Drifter. Nobody really travels up the ancient passage on foot. That's just asking for a face full of Saurok if you're not careful. Tell you what, Eggshell and I were just about to set off upriver to Binan Village. Would you like a lift? Sure. Survive a trip on the Spring Drifter. Yeah, sure, let's give it a go. Ever been to Kun Lai before? It's great. Long flowing farmlands, beautiful mountains, and absolutely nothing dangerous whatsoever. Eggshell says the Hosens attack Grummels. Well, yes, there are some problems with the Hosen. Tigers, says Eggshell. Look, there's some of them. Yes, and tigers. They're not very good shots, are they? Dark Hatch Saurok are very dangerous and very powerful. Yes, I can see they're looking mighty. The spears are just for show. As long as we don't get out of the boat or make eye contact or get hit by a spear, then we should be fine. Okay. Saurok are very dangerous. I'm glad you're telling me this, Eggshell. I never would have guessed otherwise. It's safe. I bought Lord Worker Cho and his strange companions up this way not long back. Oh. The orc tried to punch me. Oh. Okay. You had that coming, waving your incense around at his face. Wait a minute, something doesn't feel right about this. Here we are, look. Are those refugees? What's going on over there? Do I hear fighting? These people are farmers, not fighters. They may need our help. Right you are, Sausage. Thank you, Brewmaster Boof, for the lift. We made it. Welcome to Binan Village. Alright, so we got some Binan villagers. First things first, we'll go over here and get the flight path from Joe the Windwatcher. Yoink. Wanderer Chu. Greetings, traveller. What is the Vale of Eternal Blossoms? We're not quite there. We're just on the border, but we'll talk to him about it. Oh, of course you haven't heard of the Vale. 12,000 years ago, it was the seat of Mogul power, the heart of an empire.
Oh goodness, sorry.
Legend tells of sacred pools in there, the source of Mogul magic that allowed them to twist and shape flesh. But they could also be used for healing miracles, that is, if you believe in the legends. After the Pandaren Revolution, the Celestials agreed to seal away the veil so that the power of the pools could never be used for mischief. So, who is in the veil now? Hardly anyone. It's guarded by a group called the Golden Lotus. Members of the Golden Lotus are hand-picked by the Celestials to maintain a vigil over the veil, but very few are chosen. I've heard stories about the veil since I was a cub. Can you believe such a place actually exists? Do you think the legends of the pools are true? I wish I could see for myself. Well, we might be able to see. So we've got a quest here called Temple of the White Tiger. Have you heard the news, traveller? After thousands of years, the Golden Lotus has petitioned the Celestials to open the gates to the Vale of Eternal Blossoms. My goodness. Even now, there's a human prince within the White Tiger Temple arguing that you and the other races from the Omnimist should be allowed in. The temple is in the northeast of Kun Lai. Maybe you can convince the White Tiger to allow you inside. This is a truly historic moment, so we need to speak to Desko at the Temple of the White Tiger in Kun Lai Summit. Sure, we can do that. Is there anybody else who needs a hand with anything? just the farmers doing their own thing. And we need to talk to Mayor Bramblestaff, but there's another quest over here. From Apothecary Cheng. Greetings, Druid. Your people are inside, but first may I ask a favor?
What
Hit medicine. Our warriors are fighting to keep the Yongle at bay in the Kun Lai Pass to the northwest. Take this liniment. It is a powerful medicine that has been passed down in my family over the generations. Use the Dijiao to heal the injured warriors. If you do not have healing powers of your own to use them on. Oh, okay, so use the Dijiao or your own healing to aid 8 injured Binan warriors. You got it. So we got a couple of our guys in here. Have we? They must be upstairs.
You! Over here!
Nazgrim?
What's up?
Where are you, Nazgrim? You must
keep your eyes peeled.
Oh, right.
For the Alliance.
I mean, I can't heal you, unfortunately, bud, so you just fucking rest up. And here we need to talk to Mayor Bramblestaff. Here we are. Lovely. Welcome to Binan Village, Druid. I beg you, please help us. More strangers. This day is testing my limits. A missive from Lawwalker Cho. That's the thing we require. Ah, you're a friend of Cho's. Welcome, welcome. I would serve you a banquet, but as you can see, we're in dire straits at the moment. Say, would you be willing to lend us a hand? Clearly, you are a hero come to aid us. I wouldn't be so sure. Slay the Batari tribe in the Kun Lai Pass to the northeast, west. Until the Batari Fire Warrior is angered enough to appear, dispatch him. Slay 10 Batari tribe members in the Kun Lai Pass until the Batari Fire Warrior appears. Then kill him, and we will receive the Bureaucrat's Handbook, which is held in the offhand, which normally would be brilliant. But we get rid of our staff for it. So, but it's still a good quest. So the Yongle. There's also a quest. Oh, wait, no, tell a lie. Another handful of treats.
I hope you find
there's another
you
quest here, but I will. Yeah, I'll make this in my own. I feel like that's the right thing to do. And there's the handful of treats. Hello, what's this? I have a soothing spearmint candy and a human female mask. Honestly, uncanny. You'd never know. So we're wearing this for the rest of the time here. Alright, the Yongle, who is, I don't know whether or not you can tell, a Mongolian references. But I'm sure that was quite obvious already.
Hello.
Commander Say, as soon as these reinforcements arrive, the Yongle are going to overrun our position here. If they do that, the village will be lost. Would you be willing to retrieve as many arrows off the battlefield as you can carry? I have a plan that might just save us with your help.
Yeah,
sure,
please.
We can do that. So we have a injured warrior. We will heal that, and then we'll give it this as well. So these Batari Yongle. They look very similar in terms of character models to our dear Thundercall here. There we go. And look over here. Enraged cavaliers over in that village. Get these flame callers here. our own healing is really going to be helpful. We're probably going to have to use the special ointment. Yeah. I just don't think our healing is that good. I mean, actually, tell a lie. No. Is that enough, though? It's only the bottle that it actually heals, so we'll just use the bottle. The bottle's probably going to be a lot easier and save us a lot of mana. Should be able to get him in a sec. Didn't even get all 10. Didn't really need to get all 10 turns. These arrows are going to be difficult for me to grab, I think.
Expecting to pull the other one with him into the playhouse.
There we go, we've marked that down, and we don't have that far to go back. In fact, we're right there, so. As well as could be expected. We just need two more Batari tribe members and a fuck ton more arrows. I can see the little flashes, which make it slightly easier, but it's not that much easier.
Yeah.
though, the astral storm doesn't do as much as you think it does. And as these guys are kind of distracting them, I can just go around and grab the arrows, which might make it slightly easier. Isolated thing, I think. Right there. That works nicely for me. See the Yongle reinforcements massing on the horizon. That's 12, man. You've saved our defensive line here. This next attack won't have been possible without you. You flatter me. Is there going to be some kind of cutscene, or are we just going to... No, okay. We'll run away. We have some stuff to hand in. And then we got to go all the way up there to the Temple of the White Tiger, which is going to be a bit of a trek. But, we'll see how well that works for us. Mayor Bramblestaff here. We are delivered. I was right about you. And here's book, which is worth 5 gold, which is useless to me. You have saved Binan Village, Thundercall. Ring the gong so all shall know. Alright, fuck. And then for you, Apothecary Chang. Hit medicine. You have my thanks. You have shown great honor through your actions. I hope that my family's the Zhao was of some use. It was entirely everything. And General Nazgrim has awakened. It would seem that your General Nazgrim have awakened from his injuries. He and his people are upstairs. He's requested your presence. You got it.
You, over here.
Okay, that's what you should have. Okay.
Nothing shall stand in our way.
Where have you been? Never mind. As you can see, we survived the battle of the Jade Serpent. Unfortunately, so did they. Ah. Kun Lai summits where you're going to die. Oh, Admiral Taylor and Sully and Mishka of FI7. Right, you are okay. I am injured, but we can't stop here. The Hosen were unreliable. The Pandaren would be much better allies. You've seen the refuge.
Weary of these horde cowards. There must be someplace else in this village to rest.
Oh my god, Admiral, shut the fuck up. I'm trying to talk here. You have seen the refugees in this village and heard of
peaceful, kind people of this land. They were born to belong to the Alliance.
Can you shut the fuck up? And heard the Yongle invasion now.
Wait until you're healed to finish you.
My axe will soon feast.
Let it not
upon
be said
blood,
the Alliance
human.
Has no honor.
We've heard from the locals that East Wind Rest, a nearby village, was destroyed by the Yongle. Apparently some survivors have gathered along the road out of town. Go, take the road west, gather the survivors. We'll help them rebuild. Then they will see the advantage of joining the Horde. So we need to speak to farmhand Ko and Elder Shao in Kun Lai Summit. We can do that. Don't kill each other for now. Kill each other later. I will see if I can do a little cheeky repair with the metal pull. Oh, hello. And we got some up-to-date gear. Does it look any good? It kind of does, actually. It doesn't look half bad. 99. Yeah, everything I have is better than what that is. Apart from that trinket. Healing and damaging spells of a chance to grant. spirit strike. So it'll give me more spirit, less haste. I'll leave that for now. Because I can guarantee that if I was to do that, I would probably just lose it immediately after. So there is also a quest over here. If that's correct. Yeah, it looks like a quest over there. Alright, hang on, let me go and have a look over there. Oops, wrong one. There we go. Just double checking, because I saw it on the map. Ink Gilmere. Oh, Merchant She. Yes, there is a... Oh, there's a couple of quests here, actually. Alright. I took my son, they took my goods, I've lost everything. What could possibly have changed these Jinyu? My son. Can you help me find my son? When the Jinyu attacked, he ran off in the confusion. I don't know if they've done anything with him or if he's still alive even. Nothing else matters if I can't find him. I'd ask May, but something's wrong with her. She seems too impulsive since the attack. I just can't trust that she'll bring him back safely. Sure. Find Wu Peng in the Ink Gilmere. We can do that. And then repossession. Of course, the first priority is finding my son, but if we save ourselves only to starve, then what have we accomplished in the end? Please, I need you to recover some of the supplies that the Jinyu took from our caravan. So collect 8 stolen supplies. You got it. Okay, Sword Mistress May. The Sword Mistress does not look well. There's a darkness to her eyes, uncharacteristic to the Pandaren. I don't think I've ever been as furious as now. What betrayal. I thought them off when they attacked, killed a few here, but Merchant She is too much of a coward to let me go and finish the job. You do it for me. Kill them. Kill them all. Well, goddamn. Kill 5 enraged Jinyu and we'll get one of the coolest pole arms in the game, or an ornate mace. We can't really do anything with that, but then also, Water Speaker Goral might be able to tell us. My people corrupted. Shai Hu, a local warrior, was the first to drink of the tainted waters. He was strengthened, emboldened, and urged the others to do the same. I warned them against it. I sensed danger, corruption. The Water Speaker's staff. There is a great dissent in Ink Gil, Tauren. Elder Shai Hu drank the Shah corrupted waters of the mere and forced the others to do the same. When I protested, Orochi of the town guard confiscated my ritual staff and banished me. Now I am not only in exile, and I am unable to speak with the waters that once gave me guidance. I'm not a fighter, but if you are, perhaps you can recover my staff from Orochi. He is in the town to our north. So we need to recover his stolen Ink Gil ritual staff. And please accept my ancestor's blessing. It is not much, but it's all I can give without my staff, and it will help you traverse the mere. The ability to walk on the water. Oh, sick. Not all of my fellow villagers from Ink Gil are corrupted. Many heeded my warnings and did not drink of the Shah-tainted waters. They are in hiding, terrified, and intimidated by the guards. Please, tell them there is hope. Go into the village to the north, speak with them, and send them to me. So we need to rescue 8 Ink Gil dissenters in Ink Gilmere. We can do that. And check it out, we can also walk on water. Sick. So, gonna kill ourselves some Jinyu. I think this is the first time we're properly going up against Jinyu, I think. Oh no, second time. We did some just outside. Oh no. That place, I can't remember. Over by the Hosen, I think we had to kill some Jinyu. Over that way. Get this enraged spearman. We just threw the spear at him. There's no hope. Our people have lost their minds. There is still hope. Gorai is still alive. To the south. Go. Gorai lives. I'll go find him. Thank you, friend. You're very welcome, Sausage. Or shall I call you Fish Finger? In this case. Fish Finger. Oh, it's such a cute little thing. I could go for a Fish Finger sandwich, actually. Holy shit, I could go for one of them right now. We don't have any bread in the house, God. Shit a lot. I've been thinking thoughts about that. I don't even know if we've got fish fingers. Okay. That's gonna be on my mind for a while at least. Oh, shadow of pain. Spell blade of the undertow. That's a dagger. Oh. Alright, hang on. What if I do this? Equip it. And that. I do more damage a second. I don't know. Well, let's let's say Horde player, Alliance player. Let's try it. We'll keep that on us for now. That might end up actually being quite useful. I'll make my way to the south. We'll see if it makes a distinct difference in how much damage we do. Gives us better stats overall. Like, we'll keep the meditation staff on us, but like, I don't know if that's going to do us any better in the long run, because I guess it would be for both. Two would probably be better than one. The only difference would be I can't summon. Jinyu operate in a strict caste society, clearly evidenced by the stone tablet engraving with names. Eggs are sorted early on basis of the needs of the community. Many Jinyu are cast as workers, diligently put to work building dams or other structures. Others are selected to be craftsmen or immediately undergo a rigid apprenticeship on hatching. Only warriors and priests are given access to the most food and the finest shelters. The only, and only the most successful of priests can ascend to the role of elder or water speaker. It is a taboo for the Jinyu castes to intermingle. Yikes. We will get this game here. I think after this, I'll have a quick look into it. I really just don't know. I've never had a book as an offhand weapon, I guess. It's just never been done for me. So what I'll do is I'll go through my spell power and all of the spell power stuff with the staff and with oh dear, I knew I'd get one of them. I'd do it with the staff and then I'll do it with this spell blade, because that would be really useful if it was. I don't know, I just feel like we've had the staff, or staffs I should say, for so long. Way, because we've killed everything already. And there's Orachi. And there's some untainted supplies. We've got a couple down here, actually. Staff. And look, there's some shower energy coming out from him. There we go. Snake helm of the monkey. That might also be something useful. It is not, for it is male. There's two more supplies. We've got the guy. There's the untainted supplies. And there's a quest handed over here. Can you see that? Yeah, there's someone behind this shell. Ah, it's Wu Peng. My son. Ah, so horrible. When I saw the killing, I just ran. My father, may are they alive? Next, yes, they are, sausage. They survived. My father is alive. I thought we'd all die here in this horrible mirror at the hands of these insane Jinyu. I would find my way back. Meet me back at the camp. Okay. Return to Merchant Xi and Wu Peng at the southeast shore of Inkilmir. Okay. That's lucky. I didn't really fancy an escort quest. God damn it. Are you shitting me? Am I escorting you? I think I am, aren't I? I hope not. Am I escorting you? No. Oh, thank God. All right. Make your way back over there. Then we got to go and speak to these guys. So back over we go. But I'll hop on a Kodo. Because we have water walking, this will make it slightly easier. See if we can dodge these guys. Look at the Shah, it's taken over so much. And there's Shaihu. He's the original guy to get all funky with the liquid. Funky with the liquid, are you shitting me? this way. Alright, let's handle these quests back. Water Speaker Gorai. As a Water Speaker, I perform many rituals. There is one, though, that I have never performed to purify mental corruption. Oh, you kept this fucking quiet. It's an ancient ritual, one which we have not needed since the days of legend when Shao Hao walked Pandaria. I fear we need it now. Well, here's your staff. Yes, I found it. There you are, sausage. Good. Now, we have some hope in redeeming this situation. And, with the Frida Dissenters, though we may not seem much like, or we may not seem like much from these inauspicious beginnings, I know we will rebuild. Thank you, friend. Fucking sick. Alright. Oh, Jesus, Father, look at him go. Runny bastard. Son, are you well? Yes, our friend here brought me back. I mean, I kind of didn't, but okay. Repossession. Yes, I found your supplies. Thank you. We will eat now, at least. And you found him. This is all I have to give you in finding my son. You have more than earned it. Oh, sick. You gonna have a talk, or are you just gonna chill? Wu Peng, I can talk to you. It's funny, I think my father is happier now that I have returned than he ever was before. It seems like that trying times have reminded him to appreciate simplicity. Sword Mistress May. It is satisfactory to hear that our enemies are dead. Perhaps you can use one of my bodyguard's weapons. Well, I feel like it will probably be the mace.
Stay focused.
There we go. Now, given the choice between the mace, which is here, and that spell. Oh, yeah, it's way better than that. Alright, cool. Yeah, 40. Okay. Right, I'm very quickly going to pop this on. So, what I'm going to do to save a bit of time. There we go. So, I've taken a picture of that, and I'll keep that on me. Now, I will pop on the ornate mace and the book. Where's the book? Here. Pop that there. Okay. So, wielding the mace and book, our health went up a bit, our mana stayed the same. Our spell power went up. Haste has gone down a bit, hit chance has gone up, mana regen has gone up, combat regen has stayed the same, crit chance has gone up, mastery is down a little bit, and PvP power. Armor is the same, dodge the same, PvP, okay, ranged NA, DPS NA, haste 14. Haste has gone down a bit, hit chance has gone up, crit chance has stayed the same, expertise, zero, mastery, lower on mastery, okay. Interesting, so I think overall it's better than the staff, that's good to know. We have one more quest here that we'll get started. For the The moment I first rose from the river, I knew I was destined to be water speaker. I was taught many rituals and have performed all of them, save one. There was one, an extremely ancient one, that we were told to call upon if our people ever turned against us. This must have happened in our people's distant past, because we haven't needed to use it in our village's memory. I suppose now's the time to do so. So we'll speak to him and complete the ritual. Alright, let's do that. I'm ready. Begin it. Alright. I've never performed this ritual. I don't know what will happen exactly. It's been passed down from ancient times, but none of our people have needed to use it since then. Rajah. Let us see if this is sufficient to cleanse the corruption from my people's souls. It worked. Oh. Oh dear. What's happening? Why is the ritual affecting her? Because she's got loads of fucking hatred in her. That's right, I'll get it. Don't mind me. There we go. Nice one. I feel so much calmer. What happened? A beast emerged from you when I began the ritual, and I killed it. I felt a presence, a burning pain, and a rage in my mind. That thing must be what was controlling the villagers. I now know what we must do. I see now that this ritual rips out whatever was causing, whatever was controlling the minds of these creatures from them. I now know what we must do. Pools of the same murky substance that came out of May emerged in the lake recently. I will travel into the mere with you. Point out the pools of corruption that you are ready for me to cleanse. You will need to deal with whatever comes out and protect me as I complete the ritual. I think we've got time to do this one. Point out pools of corruption in Engil Mir to the water speaker and let him know you're ready to defend him while he completes the ritual. Alright, let's go. You got a mount? No, you do not. I imagine it's those bubbly bits. Or these. There it is. Those are the pools of corruption. We can deal with that. We can deal with that. As long as fucking Pinky and Perky on the air. On that. Don't interrupt us. Okay, we're good. Now, friend, prepare to defend whatever emerges. Yeah, go on. Six. Okay, sure, we can do that. We'll try and do as many as we can. A lot of these kind of get in the way of other ones, so as long as I bitter, and not that anyone's counting. I've started this quest. I'm going to finish it up, so it might be a slightly longer episode today. Though I don't know if that's ever really a bad thing with this sort of stuff. So it seems like we'll need to take out these other guys first before we even start on the ritual. just reminded me that the clocks go back, forwards. No, back. So we get an extra hour in bed, which will be nice. I'd forgotten about that entirely. Right, we're out of that one's range, so we should be able to do this. I fear I might have to. It's got a minute. Okay. Let's make this one the last one. We can pick up the rest of this quest a little later. We'll continue this next week from this area. Once this quest area is done, we're going to follow up on Eastwind Rest and then see if we can make our way over to the Temple of the White Tiger at some point later on. But you can see there's these little quest areas dotted around the area, so we have a lot of things to do. Just by leveling today, we've done 3 bars worth of XP. So it's not like there won't be enough for us to do. I feel like we'll have plenty to do. So thank you very much, everybody. Take care. Stay safe.